This is the Stormy Bass Drive by EWS out of Japan. Let's check it out! EWS first appeared on my map when they re-released Exotic Trilogic, one of my all-time favorite bass preamps, in a small footprint. The original pedal was huge, and what EWS did with the circuit was what the world was waiting for at the time. Still an amazing pedal, check it out if you're not familiar with it. They also make the BMC or bass mid control, a small and seemingly unspectacular mid EQ pedal that can save your butt in many situations. The Stormy Bass Drive is their first bass overdrive pedal. The Stormy Bass Drive comes in this pedalboard friendly format but still has all the controls that you need. We have a gain, a master volume, a tone control, which is a passive high cut filter, and we have a tiny 3-way switch that can either leave the mids where they are, boost them by 6 dB at 750 Hz, or cut 6 dB at 400 Hz. A little something they took from the Trilogic preamp circuit. When you're standing in front of an amp and you use it, it only takes a moment to figure out which one works best for your sound. The gain range on this pedal is extremely wide. When you leave the gain control at the zero position, you pretty much have a clean boost, but if you dial it all the way up, you basically become a wrecking ball for the whole neighborhood. And of course, there's everything in between. The internal power socket converts the 9 volts coming from a power supply or from a battery into 16 volts to give you just all the headroom that you need. And yes, you can actually use this with a battery, which is crazy considering the small size of the pedal. Of course, there are different types of bass drives, but honestly, I'm not entirely sure yet where to put this one on the map. What it does best, at least in my opinion, are high gain sounds. They're cutting and brutal, but carefully filtered, so the drive doesn't add any low end build up that will make you disappear in the mix. It's a precise tool that you either like or you don't, I guess. And by the way, all the sound samples in this video were recorded through my Fender Bassman 50 an old tube amp for the warmth and how you would actually use such a pedal, and we had this ready tube DI for the clarity, and these signals were mixed together depending on each sound, so this is not always the same. At the end, there's one little thing that I have to criticize a little bit about this pedal. I just wish it had a blend control. I think especially with this type of drive, this is a very useful feature to maintain your bass sound by keeping some of your clean sounds in. Of course, here in the studio, I could have done this easily, just recorded parallel another clean track, but I think to give you these kind of sounds, they would probably sound a little bit better, but I would consider this to be a little bit fake because this is something that you couldn't easily reproduce with your live setup. So yeah, that's just the way it is. However, it's an interesting pedal. If you want to learn more about it, check the link in the video description below to the EWS website that you can read all about it. And if you have any questions, of course, just as always, put them in the comment section below. That's it from me today. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.